I am Mrs. Shabnu Nawaz from Holy Hearts Educational Academy, Raipur, Chhattisgarh. Today I am here to take the classes of class 10 students and the subject is Information Technology, subject code is 402. We will deal with the theory part, that is web applications, basics and the sessions, the various sessions of it. So let's start today. Students, today we are starting with our fifth session and the topic is online transactions. Hope you all are very much familiar with this term, that is online transaction, as nowadays for many a lot things we are using online transactions. Basically, the online transaction means the payment method in which the money or the fund is transferred online. That is using electronic methods in which we get an OTP in our cell phones to cross check for the security purpose. Hence, then we pass on the OTP, write the OTP, and then the fund is transferred using online methods. This is actually online transaction. It has various benefits like low labor cost, as if we do it without using the online methods, in that we need to pass on the money orders or the cash with a particular person to a particular place, or we need to pass on the checks. So on the basis of all these things, if we look on it, lowers the labor cost. It is automatic, it has a low risk for theft, and even the transaction speed is very much high as compared to the offline transactions and the online transactions. And it is very much convenient for the online sales also. Now, what is the purpose of online transaction? As online transactions helps us to save money, like paper is saved, which is used for making notes, time which is spent in transactions for countings and all these things are saved. Hence, the purpose of online transaction is to save many things, either in monetary terms or in manpower terms. We save a lot things using online transactions. Next, here are few popular websites which allows us the online transactions. First is IRCTC. As you all know it, IRCTC is online portal for booking flights and the train tickets. Flipkart, a lot more of shopping protocols, you all know. Portals, you all know. eBay, again an online portal for buying and selling goods. Next is Redbus, an online portal for booking bus tickets. These are few populars which has been covered in your books. But excluding all these websites, you all know much more websites for online transaction, I'm sure for that. Next is the online transaction using Flipkart. If we do an online shopping, what are the various methods to follow up for the online transaction? First of all, you all know that we need to open a browser. You need to move on to the Flipkart website. Either Flipkart or any of the shopping website, whatever you want to open. In your browser, move on to that particular website's address. And as the website opens, you need to sign up. If you want to do an online transaction, you have to have an account over there in that particular website. So here in the Flipkart account, you need to sign up, you need to create your own account using the email IDs and the password after and few formalities. After that, you had an account, whatever shopping you will do, it the money for that particular, the amount for that particular things that will be added to your account that you have created using sign up button. In that particular thing, whatever thing you have purchased, that thing will be visible, its name, its brand, along with the amount and the quantity will be displayed, and the total amount after you have purchased a lot of things and you have completed with your shopping, at the end you will find the total amount, and that total amount can be paid in any of the form, either using credit card, debit card, net banking or cash on delivery or many things. So here are few steps that I have mentioned here that with the help of which you can do the online transactions using Flipkart. So students, this particular session was just on the topic online transaction, and I have given you one of the best example of online shopping, how to do the online transaction. On the basis of that, I know that many of you have already done it, but still I am giving you an assignment. First question is, you have to write the steps for online transaction for booking the rail ticket. And I am sure many, about 90% of my students, have done the online booking of either flight or train using IRCTC. So you have to write the steps of online transactions for booking the rail tickets. And second is, you have to list 5 websites which allow the online transactions. So these are the 2 assignments which are based on this particular session and this particular video. And this, you have to write it in your computer copies that will be checked when the school reopens. We have seen the various sessions in the form of videos. Hope you all understood all the topics. Just go through the videos carefully, search for the notes in your books and in the lectures, and then further do the assignments given at the end of the session. By that time, be safe, be at home, and complete your assignments. Thank you.